Today, we're going to take a look at the Auto Away Assist for Nest Thermostat project. This will let your Nest know when you are in another room and assist with the Auto Away feature so that you don't find yourself in a situation where the Nest has determined that you are not home when you in fact are home. And we're going to accomplish this by using a particle photon device, a PIR sensor, and some free services from Microsoft Azure. To get started, you'll want to head to aka.ms/nestassist, which will bring you to this page, the GitHub repository for the Auto Away Assist for Nest Thermostat project. And we're going to head over to the link to the full instructions and walkthrough guide available at hackster.io. Now, you might be wondering why I'm building this device, because Nest devices are smart, right? They are able to determine when we're home using a variety of different features. These include motion sensing. They also can detect if a cellular device is on the same network as the Nest, and they kind of use all these other heuristics to determine whether you're home. Well, in practice, that doesn't always work out properly. There's been numerous occasions where I find myself upstairs in my office and the AC is turned off because the Nest devices have determined, because either these sensors have not been triggered or maybe my cell phone is off, that I'm not home. And then I find myself sweating in the Texas heat. It's just not fun. So Nest is aware of this issue and has created a motion sensor and monitoring thermostat that alleviate these problems. However, they only work with the Nest V3 thermostats. What we're going to build today, though, will work with any Nest thermostat, as we're going to interact directly with the API using our own hardware to tell Nest that we are, in fact, home. So the first thing we're going to need to do is obtain an OAuth token to access the Nest API. Now, for security reasons, I'm not going to walk through these details in the video, but you would follow through this in the guide, and once completed, you should have an auth token and structure ID parameter, which we will be referencing again later on in the video. Next, we're going to construct the hardware. You can use any compatible particle device. I chose the particle photon. You could even use the particle core or the recently launched particle xenon. Once you've got your device picked out, simply attach the PIR sensor with the three wires and make sure that you have the data line connected to the D0 pin. With all that up and connected, I'm going to go ahead and put my device online, and I'm going to open up Visual Studio Code and open into the Nest Motion folder. From here, you'll see the Nest Motion INO firmware, and I'm going to initiate a task with Control-Shift-P and select Particle Cloud Flash. This will flash that Nest Motion INO firmware to the particle device. You should see any moment now that it's going to flash magenta and then restart running that code. And in a nutshell, all this code does is it looks at the sensor, and when it detects motion, it publishes an event to the particle cloud, then goes into a deep sleep for a sleep interval that can be specified with this constant. Now, that's great. We're getting motion data and publishing that up to particle, but we need to get that data over to Nest in order to really tell our devices that we're home. So to do that, I'm going to head to the particle console and select integrations. And from here, you would select a new Azure IoT Hub integration. And these are pretty straightforward to set up. All it requires is an Azure account. Then you would create an Azure IoT Hub and add a shared access policy to allow the particle cloud to communicate with the Azure cloud. So I have one set up already that's flashed to the device that we just saw. And you can see that it is publishing those motion events up to particle. Now, to forward these over to Nest, what we're going to do is create an Azure function that really does nothing more than, on a triggered event, calls the Nest API using our appropriate credentials and sets the status to home. So to do this, we're going to open up the Nest controller folder within the repo, and then we're going to look at the set Nest to home function. So inside here, there is a local.settings.json file, and we're going to need to fill in the access token and structure ID placeholders with the values that we obtained from the Nest API. And then the Event Hub compatible endpoint, we're going to obtain that value by heading to our IoT Hub, selecting built-in endpoints, and then grabbing the Event Hub compatible endpoint value. Once you have those, you can go ahead and set them, and then look at the function.json file. And from here, we just need to change the event hub name placeholder to the name of our IoT hub. So in this case, mine is named Nest Motion Sensor. And once we have all of that set up, we can go ahead and deploy the Azure function locally to test it before we push it into the cloud. So I'm going to select this Attach to JavaScript Functions button, and that's going to kick off a local deployment of the function. And once that's up and running, we can initiate a motion event with the device. So I'm just going to stimulate the PIR sensor here. And that should fire an event. And once that happens, the device will turn off, and we are now located on a breakpoint that I've set inside the function itself. So you can see here, this is a great way to test these things before pushing them up to the cloud. And let's just make sure that it works. So I've got my Nest Manager open, and you'll see that my current status is set to away. I'm going to walk through the rest of this function code, and that should trigger the call to Nest's API, and you'll see that it is now flipped to home. And you might even hear the air conditioners turning on behind me. So this is awesome, but it's not the final step. We have to publish this function up into the Azure cloud so that it can run 24/7, and then we can flash this code to a number of devices and deploy them all around the house and never, ever have to worry about being told that we're not home when we actually are. So to do that, we're going to right-click the Set Nest to Home folder and click Deploy to Function App. And if you have not already created an Azure Function app, it's going to ask you to create one. So I'm going to use this one that I've already created, the Nest Motion Sensor. And it's going to go ahead and prompt you to deploy, and that will kick off the task that begins that deployment to your Azure account. So once you've done that deployment, you can log into your Azure function in the Azure portal, and we're going to test it because we want to make doubly sure that it works. So inside of this Set Nest to Home folder, there is a sample.dat file, and you can just copy the whole contents of that to your clipboard. We're going to use this to test that the function really works. So if we click on the Set Nest to Home function that was published and click on the test window, we can paste into the request body section and click run. And this will trigger our function as though it was triggered with a real event. And you'll see triggered away status set to home. Function Set Nest to Home succeeded. And this is great. That means that we are ready to rock and roll, flash devices, put them all around the house, and never, ever, ever, ever have to worry about Nest being wrong about whether or not we are home again. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Again, I want to highlight that you can get the hardware for these devices at particle.io. And all of the services that we've used here are free on Microsoft Azure. So you can set up a free tiered IoT hub that'll give you up to 8,000 events per month without any charge, which is sufficient for numerous devices around the house. And also the Azure function, which you can trigger up to, I believe it's multiple thousands of executions before it would incur charges. And you can solve this problem with Nest Thermostat not knowing when you're home simply by leveraging these technologies in your home for around the cost of $20. So it's excellent. And I hope you've enjoyed this. So feel free to leave some messages in the comments.